I know you want me. You know I want ya. I know you want me. You know I want ya.
What's worth more than its weight in gold? That's a trick question because it's not my dignity. There's iridium, there's plutonium, there's rhodium, there's iridium, there's uranium, there's plutonium, and there is FL1 flight controller from Flight 1. This is so difficult to get. You just cannot find it on any of the online websites, even in the US. So I actually had to get a used version from a friend of mine who was so kind enough to provide for me for a review and for a build. Okay, yep. I paid for it, but it was well worth it. So what's so special about it? Stay tuned and you are gonna learn something today. So what you have here is the big honking H7 microprocessor, which is 10 times faster than the F7. It says here H7 Lightning. But you see here, this is the solder only version, and you have the VTX, Vout, you have the UART2, and you have this is, I think that is the, let me see what that is. That is the cam out. So that's the V out. There's a video out. And this is cam out OSD. Not too sure what that one is. I'll have to check on that in the manual. And this is the video in. And this is the camera power. All right. So what you have here is read manual before soldering jumpers. What it's actually referring to is this jumper right here. You're going to have to solder if you want the VTX power to be battery or 5 volt. So here right now, the guy before me have already soldered the battery. And here for the camera, if you want the battery or the 5 volt, you're going to jump these solder pads right there, and you'll get the corresponding voltage. All right, so for here on this side then, what you have here is the motor connections and battery. So this top one, let me see what that is the VBAT power. This is the VBAT power right there, and that's ground. This is the current telemetry, M1, M2, M3, and M4 is going to be the bottom one. All right, so I'm not too sure why these two pads right there. I'll try to figure out at the end. All right, so for this one, you have the 5 volts, you have the UART 5, and then you have the UART 3 over here. That's fairly straightforward. And now here you have the buzzer, and then you have the UART 1, you have the 5 volts. So the layout for solder pads is, I think, much more convenient, much more reliable compared to using the connector-only version. For the connector, you can always rip that off, but it's harder to rip off the solder pads. So we're gonna do a test run this morning on the H7 Lightning, and I put it on an Apex frame. And if you've already followed my channel, you actually realize that I'm a proponent of this clone frame because of the key lock that is you can put inside, and then it holds the arms. It basically then transfers all of the vibration between the front arms, the back arms. It shares the load, and then it minimizes the frame resonance. And I really think that's very critical for the H7 Lightning flight controller, because you really do not want any noise to confuse the FalcoX. Supposedly it has the filtered AI, but to me right now, your key components in order to make this quad fly great is gonna be low resonance frame. So keep that in mind. And for me, I'm using the Apex frame. What I actually see inside the FalcoX OSD. All right, so right now I have the preset to be custom. It was actually the Blackbird Next Level. The only thing I changed was on the axis roll, I made the D term to be exactly, just like, oh, and I need to go up. Okay, so I just changed the D term for the pitch and the roll to be the same 380, because previously the roll was 385 and I just wanted it to be the same. Okay, so if you look here, I have the presets for the rates at Vannevar V1, and the filters, I left it at default, and dynamic AA is enabled. So Cerebro 1.0, let's enable that. and that is the AI. Okay. Alright. For some reason, wanted power, 800 milliwatts. That's what I want. Set wanted settings. Sending settings. Okay, for some reason, VTEX power, 200 milliwatts. Not sure why. Maybe it's a display issue. We'll have to check with an RF meter. For now, I'm just going to test first. Okay, UART2 is smart audio. UART3 is crossfire. That is actually my Expresslrs. I'm using the EP2 Happy Model RX. Okay, so now we will arm number one, arm number two, go a little bit slow. Okay, I'm gonna have to get used to the rates and the throttle a little bit, because usually I add an expo in beta flight, but in Falco X I'm just using the defaults. Let's see. Okay, so now flip. Okay, no prop wash. Okay, a little bit of bounce back right there on the roll, on the pitch axis. No. But maybe because my rates are so slow. If you can see the black lines on the TBS, it's nothing to do with Falco X, it's probably the VTX. Okay, no bounce back, no bounce back. On roll, again, pitch. Okay, yaw. Nope. Okay, those lines on the VTX are a bit distracting, but that's TBS for you. So now, it's time for some freestyle.